Okay, HOCD and why I'm giving you full permission to give up. I know this is such a weird setup, just ignore it for the time being, but let's just head straight into it. The problem with HOCD is that you're spending way too much time ruminating, thinking, just don't think. No, actually, I'm kidding, but if it were that easy, I would tell you just to not think, because I know we get really caught up in those cycles and those what-ifs and those really weird, irrational possibilities that HOCD gives us constantly. It's 24/7, every day, if you're anything like I was, and it never really does stop. So I want you to, every single time you get a thought, an urge, a feeling, and don't shove it down or push it away, but instead say either, I don't know, yes, totally. Yes, I am freaking fruity. I love being fruity. And, let's say you're a guy, which I don't even have enough views to see my demographics, but I know there are more, which is actually very pathetic, but I know there are more guys than girls watching this. So if you're a guy, yes, I love kissing guys. Oh my God, I love men. Yes, men. We love men. And just agree with it. Or you can say, maybe, maybe not. I know the whole, maybe, maybe not thing gets very annoying. It got annoying to me. Like, it just angers me. Like, why do I have to constantly say maybe, maybe not to it? Because reassurance obviously does not help. I guess that would be the most clean-cut answer to that question. Why do we have to keep saying maybe, maybe not? It's annoying, but seriously, every single time you get a thought or urge, say either yes, totally, or maybe so, maybe no. That made no sense. Anyway, you get the point. And another thing with reassurance is, it never lasts. You guys probably know that. I've watched like a million videos on HOCD, and so have you. I know you guys have. And although you may have a 30-minute lunch break where you feel completely relieved, after that 30 minutes, that half an hour, it's just gonna come back. Maybe even worse, which is scary. Oh my God, that's scary. But the point is, it's very, very temporary. Basically, the big message in this video is, if you don't just give up now and say, you know what, I'm just gonna chill out and listen to, I don't know, Soul Sister by Train and just bop out to that and forget about HOCD. Well, you can't really forget about it, but not take it so seriously all the time. You've won, first thing, and you're gonna start living again. That's the whole point, is that it's taking up way too much of your time. I know I'm very type A, I know everyone says that, but I'm always working on schoolwork, my vlog, my support group, what else? Now YouTube. So I don't really have time to constantly be thinking about it and constantly be worrying about it, and neither do you. So the good news is you don't have to. You can choose not to go down that road of rumination, or checking, or asking for reassurance in any way. Because HOCD will eat up all of your time. It's like a little tapeworm. It's disgusting. Actually, it's not a little tapeworm. It's colossal. And it's just a menace to society. Like, why is it even here? I have no idea. But another message, not as big as the first one, which would be just to give up. Honestly, that's probably going to be the title of this video. But another message is, there's no valid reason to be sad about it either. I know one of the huge emotions I felt when I had HOCD, or when it was really bad, was sadness. I was just very sad about it because I was just constantly worrying, like I said before, like 1,000 times, and I didn't really know if I would ever find an answer. The answer is no, you're never going to find an answer. But it does get less stressful over time, so there is no valid reason to be sad about it. It's really just a mental disorder. It's, you can water it down to any other theme of HOCD, or not HOCD, but OCD, like checking the locks 1,000 times. It's really as simple as that, and you're definitely not alone. As I said before in previous videos and this video, I have it, and it's, yeah, it's terrible. But the more you place less importance on it, the less the thoughts will come, the less the feelings will bother you, and the urges will lessen. All of that will go away eventually. The probability of you actually being a sexuality that you aren't is very, very low. Just like the probability of, like I said, HOCD is just like every other theme, I promise you. Just like the probability of somebody who locks their house 5,000 times, the probability of their house getting robbed is pretty low. I mean, you would think if they locked their house like 5,000 times, of course nobody would want to come in. I don't know. That's just my logic. You really have to be logical about it. Like, is this even worth worrying about? The answer is always no, first of all. And the second thing you want to look at is just lessening your time that you spend thinking about it. So those are the two messages I have for you in this video. I don't know how long this is going to be. I hope I didn't drown on for too long. I know that can be really annoying and disgusting. But if you have any other questions, or you just need to vent or get advice, my Instagram is always open. It's down below somewhere, and my email is always open as well.